Hello guys, today we're unboxing the Reactor 40. This is a Garmin Autopilot. The part number is Garmin 010-00705-72. We're gonna go ahead and unbox the pump first. This is a SmartPump. Everything in the box on the pump side. All right, here's the pump itself. So we have a power and the CCU, and we got a feedback connector. Got your ports here and a port here. Some quick measurements. Pump's about 10 and a half inches long. About 7.5 inches wide. And about 7.5 inches tall. Platform for it, 7 inches by about 7.25. Sitting on rubber feet. Apparently they test these pumps before they send them out. Got a power port, CCU, and a feedback port. So that'll wrap it up for the pump. Now let's take a look at what comes in the reactor. Got a set of manuals. Now this had the GHC 20 option. That is an optional item you can buy with the pump. This is a buzzer. Shadow drive. An MEA 2000 kit. GHC 20, so that's the optional kit. Alright, so we got the, this one. This is the ECU power cable. It's a 2-pin cable, fuse link in it. Amp fuse. Next cable is the ECU to the reactor unit itself, to the pump. We got a 6-pin that goes into the reactor unit here. And then to the actual controller ECU unit. Sure. This is the NMEA 2000 network parts. Give you a power feed for it. Powers the NMEA 2000 network. Get your plug-in, wiring. Feed through. These are your end terminals here, so on the network you have to have end terminals, so you get male and a female end terminal. Get two connectors. These will basically screw together. This gives you your backbone, and this goes up to your devices, so you'll have your Chartplotter on one and the Autopilot on the other, or it'll go up to the GHC unit, so you can feed in up to the GHC 20. Then this is a drop or backbone cable, so that'll feed around the network. Couple of screws you can run through and screw it down to the panel. Shadow drive. This connects in on the pump lines, just to check to make sure you're not actually feeding in input. It'll shut the unit off if you're feeding in input. Allow you to steer the boat. Buzzer. Alright, so you got a buzzer unit. Reactor 40 CCU. Two screws. And the reactor, it's got your connector coming in and your NMEA 2000 connecting into the network. Fairly small box. Total length is 6.5 inches, 2 inches high. 3.5 inches long. All right, so now we're going to look at the GHC-20. You can either buy this separately or with the Autopilot kit. Get a cover. Get the GHC-20. Get the NMEA 2000 drop cable. It's a 5-pin cable. Cover for it. An MEA 2000 network connector. Get a seal for it. Get the 4 screws. The manual set for it. Get the cutout template, the manual, and installation instructions. This is Garmin's GHC-20. It is part number 010-011-41-00 if you're purchasing it separately. The NMEA 2000 port. We've got a 7-pin port there. main cable from the unit itself. To the pump. Buzzer. Fuse. An MEA 2000 drop cable, 5-pin connector. N terminals, male and female. Power connector, an MEA 2000, and two screws, two connectors, get your backbone, then your actual unit devices, so you have your Chartplotter or your GHC 20 and your Autopilot. This directional flow switch, this will go in line to tell the unit if you're taking over with manual controls, it will shut it off. Got your manuals, the smart pump. Itself. So.